direct from Detroit, Motor City, USA. The Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the North American International Auto Show.
Our Vice President for Worldwide Sales and Service, Jerome Guillen.
Thank you. Thank you. Good morning. Can everybody hear me okay? Yes. Welcome. We're happy to host you and give you a little bit of an update about what's happening with Tesla and what's going to happen this year. So the first thing, starting with the big news, is I'm pleased to report our deliveries for the fourth quarter of last year, 6,900 deliveries, which is about 20% above the previous guidance we had given. So it's a pretty good results that we're happy with. I'd like to thank the production team and the delivery teams for bringing all these cars to the market. But overall, I want to thank our customers for showing such endorsement of the car. And we've been very pleased with all the reception and we've received with the cars. And I think there's a couple of maybe additional points that have convinced our customers that the Model S is a very good car. The first one is regarding safety. Now that we have a lot of cars on the road, people realize it is a very safe car. To date, there has been no serious injury in the Model S ever. There has been no casualty. Of course, as we put more and more cars on the road, this is unfortunately likely to change. But the fact is that for the time being, this is one of the safest, if not the safest car on the road. And we have the evidence to show it with 168 million miles on the road. And as I said, no serious injury and no casualty. In addition, besides that empirical data, the test as supported by NHTSA and other organization, proved that the Model S has the highest ratings in terms of safety. And so putting the two together, the customer says, it is a safe car. If I want my family in a safe environment, this is a good car to have. So that's one reason that we think is helping the sales to be really above our expectations. The second one really is winter has come. People can see how well the car is doing in cold weather. A lot of people appreciate the benefits of being able to charge the car, preheat the car remotely, and come to a car that is warm and ready to go fully charged. In addition, we got a lot of very good experience last week with all the cold weather and the snow in the Chicago areas and so on, where people have been delighted with their cars. And let's don't forget that our largest market outside of North America is Norway. And the Model S is the best-selling car in Norway. Not the best-selling electric car, the best-selling car, period. And these people know a couple of things about cold weather. I was there last week, and people just enjoy very much using their car. I was fortunate to go up a mountain with it, and it's, you know, it's exceptional performance in cold weather. So those two things together already have helped us and have helped our customers be even more confident that the Model S is a good choice and have helped us achieve the figures I mentioned earlier. In addition, I'd like to say on safety that we don't stand still. Although the car, we think, is already extremely safe, I can tell you that my colleagues are continue to think about ways of making it even safer. And in particular, we don't shy from providing updates over the air and sending firmware which allows the car, under certain circumstances, to have a behavior that could be even safer. While NHTSA may call this sometimes a recall, we call this modern technology. The fact is, there is no car that needs to leave the garage. We can remotely and very conveniently make the car even better. both on safety and any other features. You know, this is a this is an aspect that is very unique to Tesla, that we can make every car better over time without having to bring the car in a specific Tesla location. So all in all, we feel pretty good about this, and we look forward to 2014 with anticipation. So what's in for us in 2014? Well, growth. So on the sales and service side, which I'm responsible, it's reckless growth. You know, it's as fast can we grow. And by the way, I'd like to stress that our biggest challenge continues to be recruiting. We cannot find enough people fast enough to staff all our sales and service locations. So basically, in 2014, you should expect our sales and service presence to double. Double globally, in North America, in Europe, and in Asia as well. So if you think about it, I think we should be ready to support our expansion in production and in sales by having basically double the footprint. Both in sales and in service. So this is coming along quite well, with the challenges, though, that I mentioned about recruiting, the ability for us to recruit as fast as possible. Good people. In Europe, we continue also our presence. And in Asia, China is a market that looks very interesting to us, where we think that the Model S could do very well. We already have opened a store in Beijing. We opened a service center in Beijing as well. And we'll have many, many more in 2014. And with the first deliveries in just a few weeks, we're building the cars already for that. Yeah? And finally, to help, you know, back to the first sort of concern that there was about electric car, which was range, despite the car having 300 miles or 500 kilometer range, we continue to expand aggressively our supercharger network to allow fast and free long distance driving throughout the world. So we have now about 80 superchargers. Keep in mind that each supercharger is allowed to cover a lot of area. And also the pace of opening is quickening. So last week, I believe we opened 7 sites, and we're opening 2 today, if I remember correctly, actually in Ohio, so not far from here. And 7 million miles of charge have been provided out of, as I mentioned, 168 million miles that the customers have driven. So I can show you some maps of the supercharger routes in North America. You can see the cross-country road is almost finished, right? So stay tuned, you know. It's just a few more days until we'll have people driving across for free North America with the Model S. And in Europe, it's coming along as well. So as you all know, Norway is already covered. It's a good thing you don't need many stations in Norway to cover most of the country. You can go to the Arctic Circle, where we have our, I would say, most dedicated customer. And also, we have the road between Amsterdam and the Alps and skiing that is now open. And as you can see in the pictures, our Dutch customers are taking great advantage of it. I think we've never seen such a high utilization from superchargers than the one that we have opened in the Netherlands already. So all in all, it's doing quite well. And wanted to summarize a little bit what happened in 2013, looking forward in 2014, and give a chance. I think we have a couple of microphones on either side for some of you, probably not all of you, unfortunately, to ask some questions either to me or to my colleague Dharmit. Yeah? Go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay. Jim Motovalli from the New York Times. You didn't mention the Model X, and some people thought you were going to show it here. Can you talk about where you're at with the Model X introduction?
Yes. So Model X is being worked on feverishly. So a lot of the people you don't see here today are working on Model X. And I wanted them to be here, but you know, they're working on it. The launch, the official launch for the Model X, you know, typically we have our sort of Tesla events either at the factory or the design studio. So that should be happening in the future. But I'm sorry, but it'll be here at some point. But we'll have an event before that in the West Coast. Yeah. Yeah. Go ahead. Yeah.
Bruce Kennedy with Benzinga.com. If you look around the floor here, you're seeing a lot of other electronic vehicles being introduced or prototyped. Are you worried about market share in the upcoming 5 to 10 years?
So repeating the question, it was hard to hear. So are we worried about other electric vehicles? Absolutely not. We welcome them. The mission of Tesla is to accelerate the transition to sustainable transportation. So the more electric vehicles there are on the street, I think the better off we are, all of us. You know, I'm delighted to see the electric smart from my former colleagues across the street, across the aisle, I should say. You know, I'm delighted to see all the other electric cars, the B class over there that we're involved with. We welcome all the electric cars. I think all electric cars are good and are contributing to that overall mission that we're trying to achieve. Yeah.
Esben, over there.
Hi, Chris Damaro with gas2.org. What's up with the battery swapping stations? I thought we were supposed to have those by the end of the year, and what's the progress on that?
Yeah.
Sure. We are still on track to introduce some battery swapping options. It's, as Elon characterized it when we talked about it middle of last year, it's something that we're exploring. To see what customer interest is in that, and so you'll see some progress on that in the coming months.
And I have to say, people love the supercharger so much. You know, I receive dozens of emails nearly every day asking me, open a supercharger there, and I need a supercharger there to see my cousins and so on and so forth. You know, I think we're responding to a huge demand on superchargers, and that's where our efforts are. Wish we could tackle all challenges at once, but we try to respond to customer demand there. Yeah. Maybe on that side, maybe, Esben?
Mike Strong with the Detroit Bureau. Can you give us some updated sales expectations for 2014?
I cannot do that. You know, I'm an officer and I'm restricted in what I'm able to say publicly. You know, but what I can say is that we will be ready. You know, number one, we have plenty of room in the plant to grow. Those of you that have the chance to come visit us in Fremont could see that there is plenty of room that we're not using yet, that we will be eventually using for Model S, Model X, and the third generation vehicle. And then, as I showed earlier, we will have all the sales and service locations to support the growth that we expect. Yeah? No different numbers than the ones that Elon had communicated earlier. Yeah? Over there.
Hi, Rosa Kazan with CCTV America. You're doing quite well in the luxury electric car segment, but how are you planning to compete for, you know, the average customer and make electric cars more affordable?
How are you planning to compete in the lower segments?
We have Elon communicated many years ago the overall plan to increase, strategic plan. You know, we started the Roadster, which was a limited series, 2,500 units overall, high performance, high price. Then we migrated into Model S, you know, which is still a relatively expensive car, a luxury car. And then we'll have a cousin or based on the same platform with the Model X. You know, 3 years from now, it's our intention, or about 3 years from now, to launch what we call the third generation vehicle, which would cost about half the price. And will be really at that time, you know, a greater volume. Yeah, that has been the plan from the beginning, the strategic plan, and we're sticking to it. Yeah, on that side, maybe somebody. Okay, Sim, don't worry too much. Yeah.
Thank you. Eric Novak, EnviroDad.com from Canada. And I'd like to ask if you could maybe update some of the status of the supercharger network that you're trying to lay across north of the 49th. I know you're working with Sun Country. Can you give us an update on that?
Yeah, so for our Canadian neighbors, actually I like to say to the south in Detroit, you know. I used to live in Detroit, that's an interesting fact. We already have a supercharger, to go to Whistler. On the West Coast, and we're planning the main route, Toronto to Montreal. Construction to start as soon as weather allows. So that's where we start. But that said, you know, I want to say that in Canada, there are a lot of stations that allow CHAdeMO charging, and so we have a CHAdeMO charger that people can get and make use of all those CHAdeMO charging stations in Canada. So people are not left, you know, without any option. I agree, we need to do supercharger between Toronto and Montreal and Quebec City, really. I've heard it many times, and we'll start construction as soon as weather allows. I know. Well, thank you. We appreciate the support in Toronto.
Hello, Angelo Young with International Business Times. I just wanted to know if the Gen 3, because it's going to be a smaller car, how will that affect range? I mean, is it going to be kind of in the same range as the small electric cars that we have?
So what will be the range of the third generation car? It will be a practical range. Okay, something that allows everybody to do whatever they want and don't feel restricted in any way. The approach we're taking at Tesla is a no-compromise approach. Nobody should feel sorry for driving an electric car. And if you buy a third generation car, you will not feel sorry, you will feel proud, just like our current customers feel proud with their Model S. Okay, let's just continue.
Dave Shepherdson, Detroit News. Given the NHTSA Model S investigation, are you any closer to making any improvements to the undercarriage to prevent roadway debris from sparking additional fires beyond the ones that Elon's already announced?
Well, yeah, we have already implemented some improvements, as I said, as you pointed out, with over-the-air firmware updates. As I said, my colleagues never stop working, and we're always looking for ways to improve even further. I don't know any specifics at this point or any timing for any specifics, but I can tell you certainly that we do not stand still, and we always look for ways to improve, you know? And that's the way we are, you know? We're a startup with a small company from California, but we will always try to look to improve, yeah? Okay, maybe in the middle, and... Okay, Esben, show us your skill at mic throwing. He's from Norway, ask him how it drives.
Hi, I'm Marcus with Xinhua News Agency. Can you go into a little more detail on your plans for China in terms of and how things are going so far in terms of production and supercharging stations?
Well, we will make sure that we have all aspects to support our growth in China. At the moment, it really is about opening more sales locations and service locations beyond the ones we currently have. But we will make sure that all aspects are covered. Again, we're growing the team by leaps and bounds in China. That's our biggest challenge, and I feel pretty confident. Despite some of the limitations we have, given our small presence at the moment, I have to say that the receptions have been quite positive, and the perception in China, and I want to show appreciation there for Tesla has been very good. And we will make sure, without going into more details, that the Chinese customers are well taken care of. And we will recognize their appreciation for us. Okay, maybe on that side. Yeah.
Yes, hi, Stephen with Sun Country Highway. Just wanted to know about the recall on the level 2 charging adapters. What's the time frame for delivery in Canada for those? Or if there is a recall in Canada as well as US?
Well, maybe I wasn't explicit enough earlier. The recall is about installing what is being considered a recall, although really the word should be changed because the car doesn't have to move physically, is a firmware update that actually nearly all cars have already received. So So I think, you know, we're going to be having some discussions about the appropriateness of using a word that has no physical sense, right? So all cars, nearly all cars, you know, more than 99% of cars, as far as I remember, already have the fix. So there is nothing to do. No. So we're going to go belt and suspenders, you know, as I explained earlier. But the fix is a firmware update that nearly all cars have already received. And we'll have to track the cars that we can't reach over the air, but we will do that, yeah? Do you want to add something else? OK, maybe on the right side or the left side. OK, go ahead, Esben, yeah?
Hello, I'm from Handelsblatt in Germany, Thomas Jahn. There are reports in Germany that sales are disappointing, and you pointed out Norway as the largest market in Europe. So how do you see the demand there? Could you get an update, please?
Well, demand in Norway is good. I was there, you know. I was also in Germany last week, in Frankfurt and Munich and Stuttgart, you know. For having lived in Germany for a few years, I know that it's a little bit more cautious approach to a circumspect approach to purchasing cars. So we need to deliver all what is needed for a proper purchasing experience in Germany. So if you look about it, we have opened the service centers. So now people know that the cars can be serviced. We have a lot of service locations that was missing. We have opened the supercharger route, you know, and we have offered since last week a very competitive financing product, which we didn't have. We don't have yet the benefit of a captive financing institutions, but we have to have to offer some attractive financing product. So that's the case already in since last week. And then, of course, the big question for cars of that size in Germany is leasing program, right? And we are finalizing this, and it should be released in the next few weeks. I know that Germans appreciate good cars. You know, I contributed to building them over there. So I think they will love the Model S. Okay. Just take a mic so that everybody can hear your question.
Thank you very much. Even though you are saying that the recall situation that was discussed before is under control, here it is coming out at a time when you're bringing out the best that you have to offer and putting on the best face. My question is, are you concerned that this would hurt the image of the company and impact future sales?
Not really, because I think it is now, I think, apparent to everybody that we continue to take steps to make the car better over and over. You know, we send a firmware to make it look better. You know, if NHTSA wants to call that a recall, so be it. But that's not going to stop us from doing the right thing, which is to make sure that the cars become better and better. And that's our approach, that's our North Star, and that's what we're going to keep doing. Let's wrap it up.
Thanks. Andrew Collins from Jalopnik. We've heard rumors that Tesla's got a utility, potentially pickup vehicle in the works. Can you speak to that?
You guys have a lot of rumors, I think, you know. No, I think, first of all, I wouldn't announce our product plans here, but we have our hands full with what we have already, the Model S, continued improvements, Model X, starting to work on the third generation car.
Maybe one more question.
Maybe last question. What's for lunch?
The supercharged network in the other electric cars, have you guys talked at all about making them universal so that the expansion of electric cars becomes, you know, there's gas stations everywhere that multiple cars can stop at?
Yeah, so the intention of the supercharger network is to enhance our customer experience. That's where it started from, and delivering the best technology to do that. The quickest technology is consistent with our what we perceive to be our leadership position in this arena. We are not, as Elon himself has said, we're not excluding the possibility that other manufacturers might want to adopt this technology themselves. But right now there are no plans for that, but really it's incumbent on others to come to us. Certainly though, there's a lot of interest from our OEM colleagues in the success of the supercharger network, which has exceeded the market's expectations, exceeded our expectations. Mm-hmm. And so there's continuous interest no firm plans at the moment. And with that, I want to thank you all for coming. Those of you who know Jerome knows he would stay here all day doing this, but you have other things to do, so do we, and we thank you again for your interest. We're overwhelmed by your interest, and we look forward to seeing you again next year. Thank you very
much.
Thanks for watching The Auto Channel. For more great coverage of all major motor events, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive resource.